live.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Nick Arojo, and I am here with Mr.
Paul Merritt.
Paul Merritt. So, the objective of our broadcast today is to share with you, and anyone can get involved and ask questions. We're going to go through what being an Arojo ambassador really truly means, the connectivity that you would get by getting connected to Arojo, and then we're also going to go through every single one of our Arojo products to give you some proper knowledge on the positioning of the product, why we use it, when we choose to use it, and then we're also going to discover American Wave, because Arojo, you know, proudly off has two brands. One is Arojo, and the other brand is American Wave, and American Wave is not just a hair care line, it's actually a service too. So we're going to spend the next 45 minutes to an hour covering the objective of really letting people know the benefits of getting connected to the ambassador program, and of course product knowledge. Paul Merritt is our artistic director for the cosmetology school, but your career is so much more than that, Paul.
Yeah, so I've been hairdressing, started at Vidal Sassoon many years ago. Ended up coming to New York with a big agency called Jedru, doing editorial, as people say, so kind of working for brands. So working for brands like Ralph Lauren, Vogue, Harper's Bazaar, all these different kind of projects, working with photographers. I come here and I ended up staying. And then worked with Nick as just coming in, doing a few little projects. And over time, I've kind of fallen in love with the product, fallen in love with being in a team again, and started to work with Nick, working on the brand, kind of helping with the product. Now working in the school, so watching young talent come through the brand, which is really exciting. I've seen people go from not knowing how to do any hair, being on the salon floor doing hair, which is like so rewarding. And all the experience I've had from working with all these different kind of fashion high-end brands, I kind of feel like I'm filtering that now at grassroots level, which is exciting.
And really, Paul, because you do a big piece in really the last 2 years of helping to test drive the product.
Yeah.
So even though we work with some of the finest chemists across America,
yeah,
you're kind of like so used to working with products and looking,
yeah,
for performance.
It's interesting because when you sort of get a product in your hand, I would probably use a product slightly different to what a hairdresser would.
A hairdresser mean like in the salon?
In the salon.
In the salon.
So I would load up a lot more product. I would use a lot more product. And
right,
that's where you really see the performance.
Right.
Because the product can break down if you use a ton of it.
Gotcha.
So when I first met you, I remember I used to sneak in the back door and try and get volume foam, wave mist.
Yes,
I know. They were like my favorite.
Yeah.
They were the ones I was using for the, I could load it up. And then more I got involved, we kind of started to get to know all the products.
And you started to explore
different
things.
And then I've helped you kind of bring out
some of the new ones.
Some of the new ones.
Yeah.
So for me, it's a real creative product,
mm-hmm,
that crosses over into kind of the world that I was in, and certainly from a salon performance as well. And watching the kids,
uh-huh,
never done hair,
right,
explore it.
Yeah, they love it, don't they?
Well, it's kind of like, sometimes I'm like, why are you using that and that?
Uh-huh.
But it's kind of always something good comes out.
So we got Paul on hand. He's going to also give us his perspective as we do product knowledge. But also, if you are part of getting connected to Arojo as a business owner, carrying Arojo product as kind of one of your styling lines, Paul is somebody that you definitely get connected with. Because we have, let's talk about the business before we get into why you would join the Arojo product ambassador program. We're a New York City based brand. We're in downtown New York, so we have a downtown vibration. It's kind of a little bit more street, but it is prestige because of our pricing is prestige pricing in the salon. So the most affordable option for a entry-level haircut in my studios, we call the salon studios because we say that the studio is the working place of an artist, and we believe to really celebrate the artistic vision of a hairdresser. The starting price for a haircut is $85. We developed a prestige product line to help support the staff in the salon so that we can get the looks that we want. Arojo as a brand, it's three salons, Three Arroyos Studios, Soho, Tribeca, and you're actually in the Williamsburg location right now. We start the business a little bit later in Williamsburg. People get up later, so that's why we're here. It's empty, which is good. We have two cosmetology schools, so we're really into grassroots education. Education is our core culture. So we have two cosmetology schools. There are education centers, one in Soho, one in Tribeca. And then we have our Advanced Academy, which we house classes pretty much every week. And our education team's on the road every week also. So very active in the educational arena. And then of course we have the Arroyo product. So basically, you know, I've been doing hair now for 36 years, I believe, maybe getting to my 37th year. Arroyo's been in business for 17 years. It'll be 17 years in September. We started off as a very small studio with a couple of chairs, and I had a vision to try to emulate and create a progressive hairdressing brand that can connect to hairdressers, consumers, and we can be a resource for everybody wanting to explore the field of hairdressing. We launched the product in 2010. We didn't launch it to salons. We launched it just to our consumers, to our clients. And I wanted to test drive the product in the salon first to see whether we could, you know, whether we could get the right formulations and the right specifications so that we could deliver, you know, what I would consider to be a performance-based brand. The number one objective at the beginning was to make the product have the performance that I believed and my hairdressers believed would work on the salon floor. The other thing that was very important to me was making the price point, the pricing of the product, making sure that it was what I like to consider attainable for everybody. So our pricing goes from $19 to $29, and I like to think of that as a prestige position, but not too expensive that maybe a consumer's gonna think twice. In fact, I think the pricing standpoint of it is something that's very powerful for us because it hits that sweet spot, and part of our mission is always to make sure that everything that we do is completely accessible. First, performance. Second, we looked at the ingredients and we said, let's make it have a vitamin or a vitamin. How do you say it in America? I'm confused now. Vitamin, yeah. So we performance first.
We obviously didn't take our vitamins.
You can say it however you want.
Yeah, performance first, a vitamin sub story, so that the product had a kind of a health, good for you, good for your hair, feeling and sense. And when we set about it, we started with 12 products. Right now we have 50 products because we've managed to really develop more specific products for specific needs. And that's the beauty of, you know, the amount of time it's taken us time to really build this line. And we're also not a company that likes to choke people with too many products.
I think it's interesting because the product performance and obviously the ingredients and the creativity hasn't been compromised. I feel with some brands you kind of get one or the other.
Right.
You don't get the whole. For me, it's been the creative thing when I first started, and then you start to look. Now I start to look at the label.
Right.
And I've got to understand what's in it.
Yeah.
So when you first start to use it, it's just for me, it was all about, is it going to perform?
Yep.
Is it going to give me the results I wanted? But then there's other layers within there.
Sure. And the other thing that I was very specific about as we started to research and do our homework and kind of get out into the country and find the right manufacturers to help us develop the product, you know, was the fragrance. Yeah, and I really, because when I look at hair products and I've been doing it for such a long time, I said, we've got to make sure that the performance is there, the packaging is simplistic so that the client and the consumer can kind of connect with the product, remember it, so it's color-coded, kind of very simplistic in design, and then we've got to make sure that the fragrances of our product are fragrances that are so notable that the client will immediately go, wow, I just fall in love with that fragrance, because I do believe fragrance is a key component. How would you describe, like, the smell and the feel of the product overall? Because I know we have, like, We have a number of different fragrances, yeah. But we try not to.
Well, last week we was looking. I was looking at fragrances. Uh-huh. Well, not looking at them. I was smelling fragrances. You don't really look at them. So, for me, it's like having something that's not going to overpower, but almost has its identity.
Yeah.
You want to be able to associate it with a certain product.
Yes.
So now it's even. I can smell it on someone's hair.
Uh-huh.
I could identify. So, which I think is really important, because so they have like. The product has a signature mm-hmm. to it on all levels.
Yeah.
And you can sort of smell it, especially with the dry shampoo. Sometimes you're walking down the street and I'm like, yeah.
I know she's come from the salon. Oh, she's going to the salon to buy another can.
Yeah.
So fragrance is very important, and obviously the texture and the feel of the product, we're going to go through all of that. The ambassador program was kind of, the idea behind the ambassador program was look at what was in the marketplace. Yeah, and you have obviously other manufacturers, and as the hairdressing market's changed and evolved, I said I want to really try and stay super true to the professional stylist. So we positioned Arojo product as a professional performance brand. We sell Arojo product to other hair salons. We have a combination of direct distribution in certain parts of the country, and we have a combination of distribution fulfillment, working with our distribution partners who are like-minded people and have an intrinsic similar vision to what we're doing. The Arojo Ambassador Program is tied 100% to education. So when you're looking at Arojo product, and if you're looking at it as potentially an option to be a brand that you would bring into your salon, what you're bringing in is not really just what's in the bottle. You're bringing what's behind the bottle. And what's behind the bottle is an immense amount of culture and an immense amount of education that we offer to support. What about our classes? How would you sum that up?
Well, just going back a little bit, I feel like now within hair, we're really celebrating the independence.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many like really good, amazing hairdressing independent salons out there.
Yep.
I feel like across all kind of topics, like even coffee shops now.
Right, right.
Everything has become more about the independent.
Right.
Rather than the big kind of franchise word that was used. You know, so mm-hmm. so I feel like it really works within that. You're an independent, but you end up joining like a club.
Right.
You get that team spirit. So
yes.
You're a part of a club. And then you've got the product, but more about being associated with the education.
Right.
So we educate from grassroots cosmetology,
mm-hmm.
the ongoing education that goes to your apprentice program.
Yep.
You know, that goes through the salon.
Yep.
And then we have like the salons come in from outside into our kind of culture and learning that way. So there's like a family, it's kind of spreads, and that's what I was attracted to.
Right. Okay, good. I agree. And I think that one of the things is, like, even if you take a stab at this week, we've already been in front of so many hairdressers with so many different things, because part of this culture, this kind of shared culture, is it's like an open door policy, and we actively go out into the field, into the country, and we're constantly sharing and educating. This week we did, we have a number of different specialized events that we purposely bring to the local marketplace, because we want what I call touch points at all times. So we have touch points with our events like Happy Mondays, Exposé, events like Arojo Underground. We have our big show coming up, Arojo Expo. So every year we map out a 12-month process and say, how can we inspire the marketplace, and how can we have touch points? And in today's world, we've really started to focus so much more on social with Arojo Social, which is our downloadable app, which is ran by the woman that's holding the phone right here, Lauren. So she's Hello. Actively connecting and communicating, so that any hairdresser, whether they're an independent hairdresser in their own location, or whether they're part of a team, and any level, whether it's a salon owner or an entry level, we're trying to connect and talk to all of those people. Some of the success points, I think Brooklyn Live, every week we dedicate an hour and a half to share the style of work that we do, and our kind of philosophy and our vision, and product knowledge while doing haircuts.
Yeah, so, and what was interesting for me when I first started to work with you, and I felt like the salon was a direct kind of impression of what you're putting out there as an image.
Mm-hmm.
The environment felt like it was real. It wasn't like just a facade of like, this is kind of what we do creatively. It comes from the kids right through to your senior stylist. So what you're putting out there and what you're doing for me represents the brand from right at the beginning, right to the end, and the education.
Yeah, well, we're trying to share the culture that we've built within the salon, and we're opening the door so that other hairdressers who want to get connected to us that maybe are not going to work for us, but they can kind of be a part of what we're doing.
It's a safe environment.
And it's a safe environment, absolutely.
It's an environment. And I find sometimes with the Happy Mondays and events like that, it's as much about the conversations afterwards and the talking to other owners and sitting around chatting as it is about actual the haircut.
Sure. I was in New Paltz this week. We did Happy Mondays. We had 115, 120 hairdressers come. We had our social piece after because we always like to do that. We had new talent, as in we had people from school, right the way through to some amazing salon owners. This weekend we'll be in Chicago doing the same thing. And this education's complimentary. I like to call this a touch point for us to meet and share. So even though we'd love to welcome more people in to get connected to our culture, we're also, even if you don't sell a Rogio product, there are still touch points for you to be inspired by. I mean, even our commitment to the trade shows this year, Paul.
Yeah, so even the presence, it's not even like it's a hard sell, it's just being there, other hairdressers kind of seeing what you're about, seeing what you're trying to do. And there's no hard sell, I was quite surprised.
Yeah.
It was more about, this is the culture, this is what we do, this is kind of where we are. And then look, I think people like that.
Yeah, they do.
Because it's from a hairdresser selling a product, working with who's created a product, who's there behind the chair doing clients still.
Absolutely. And if anyone has any questions, and Lauren, you can just shout them out. If we do come across any questions, you can certainly ask us. So really, Arogio, linked to education, linked to culture. When you purchase Arogio product in your salon, so when you purchase Arogio product and get connected to the Arogio culture, we call you an Arogio ambassador. An Arogio ambassador kind of is our tagline for the connectivity. And we're ambassadors for the craft of hairdressing. So it's not just about being an ambassador for hair product. The symbol and the intention for me is that when you become an Arogio ambassador, you're connected to our culture, the clients would know our culture, the clients would understand our culture, and this has been a long process in the making. Like I said, we've been in business now for 17 years, and we've managed to build a pretty strong reputation for quality, well-educated hairdressing, so that we're trying to push that message further out.
Yeah.
Now, in reference to the concept of getting people to understand how to sell hair care, that's part of my vision also, is whether it's my Facebook presentation that I do every week, sharing how to use the product, completely enforcing how the product can be successful for you, because at the end of the day, it is all about pure performance, look, feel, and whether you can get the looks that you want. Overall, when I looked at developing the product line, I wanted a product line that was not heavy, not sticky, not tacky. I wanted a product that was soft, that was gentle, that was very movable. Our formulations are generally quite light. I didn't focus Arogio product to be a holistic brand. We make it with 9 different chemists across America. It's made 100% in America. I think that there is something for everybody within the line. There are specified products within the line that maybe do not contain ingredients that some consumers might not want. We have a major chart that shares what products are oat-free, wheat-free, silicone-free, sulfate-free, but we didn't go out with a tagline based on, oh, let's make it an ingredient-focused brand. We made it a performance-focused brand infused with vitamins, tied to our educational system and our educational process. And the whole concept is that let's get every client to take home at least one, if not two, hair care products. And I use the product every single day in my salon, and I'm testing my product every single day. So that's kind of part of the uniqueness of the brand, because I'm the owner. We have no vested partners in this brand. It's kind of truly not a tagline. It's truly developed and built and owned by hairdressers, and that's how we've done it. So it's been a major journey, a lot of fun.
And you can see the performance in the salon.
You can see
it. From clients, from the young clients to the kind of older clients, you know, the performance has always been there, and there's a bit for everybody there. And, and then as you become more kind of informed on the product, the kind of the way you use it, it all crosses over. So it's quite
I've got clients, they say to me all the time, they open up their cabinet at home and it's just like the Arojo shelf. It's like, oh, my name everywhere, which is awesome.
Yeah.
Just some collateral here, just want to share. So we're working on our next issue of Culture Magazine. This is something that we send to salons so that you can have it, because I also want to speak to the clients in your salons. Yeah, I want to speak to your clients too and kind of show them what we're doing for the community and how we're trying to stay creative and stay on the cutting edge or on the pulse of what's modern in culture and hairdressing today. So this magazine here kind of reports back on all of the things that we've done in the past 6 months and what we're doing in the next 6 months. We're working on our next issue right now, and there'll be a nice feature on this gentleman right here. So that's there. We also have, this is our education brochure, just to share with you the type of education, and we're constantly reevaluating how we do education. So these, when I go through this booklet, all of these classes, each one of these is a class. So we have classes for everybody. Over 20 different types of class, from color to retail training, from razor cutting to scissor cutting, even to our 4-week intensive boot camp. So we've got fashion styling, pretty much every single thing that a modern young hairdresser would want to be able to dip in and learn and train and get more inspiration from. So this kind of shows you, these are the dates. And we also have partner locations across America, because our ambassadors, we've created a thing called the Style Council. The Style Council are some of our leading salon owners and leading educators that help us build in the local market. So we also have classes in Chicago, Minneapolis, North Carolina, Albuquerque, New Mexico. I think you're going there
next month.
Florida, California, and I know we're adding new locations for education as we're building this brand. So next year, expect classes in Boston, expect classes in New Paltz, because I'm definitely going back up there. And you can use what we call your reward dollars when you purchase products in your salon. Your retail can actually help to pay and support for your salon's education and your personal education. This is Arojo Social. This is updated hourly, so this keeps our footprint in the palm of everybody's hand. Any hairdresser at any time can get connected to Arojo and learn more and more about how to utilize and use the product. So that's our education brochure. Then we have our product brochure. The thing with the product, as we look at it, color-coded for simplicity. I've even seen this work when I've seen a husbands come in looking for their buying products for their wives. They say, just get the yellow one, get the blue one, get the green one. Yeah, so this is a Arojo product, and you can see right at the back we have a glossary. So this is for the consumer and for the professional stylist to learn and get a little bit more in depth. Because we are not ingredient focused with Arojo product, it's performance based. So as I go through the product knowledge in a few moments, I'm going to get into the actual performance aspect and the unique selling point of each product. So that's a beautiful brochure for a Rogier product. And I think, did we have an American Wave one?
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, there you go. So American Wave. Now American Wave, I'm gonna leave till the end, but with American Wave, we had a chance to bring out a product line focused on curl, wave, and texture. So this is a boutique prestige brand. And the difference here is we made this product line a little bit more, well, a lot more ingredient focused. You can see American Wave has a different personality. It's for curl, wave, and texture, and it's boutique. There's only 7 products in the line at present. We're working on one more product for next year. So it's very boutique-y, and it is a clean and green line. And already we've won a couple of awards for American Wave. So that's exciting. And again, we are really focusing on the professional stylist. So we now have more than just one thing for the professional stylist or the professional salon owner to get connected to. Is there anything else before we go through the product knowledge, Paul, that you think I've forgot or missed?
No, it's like the family thing, bringing everybody in, the culture through the product, through the training. I think that's the excitement about it all the time.
And we have an open door policy, which means that we have a face to the brand. We have doors to the salons in New York City. Yeah. You can walk into any of our salons, and I guarantee you can walk into any salon that carries a Rogier. You're going to get the same kind of friendly vibe, because I'm really into, we're really into being progressive and creative, but we're also really into being kind of warm and welcoming, so that we can, share what we've learned and try and elevate the standard of hairdressing. I mean, that's really kind of a big point of what we're trying to do here. We're trying to hold up the hair business at the highest possible level without the pretentiousness, but with the focus for professionalism, which, was something that I know that everybody kind of agrees on.
Yes, inclusive.
Inclusive,
yeah.
Absolutely. So now, and that's interesting, because a lot of brands or a lot of hairdressers are always looking for something that's exclusive.
Yeah.
But we've made it a key component for it to be inclusive. What that means is it means that we have standards, but it means that we're there to help you grow. We're there to help you develop your standards. We're there to help improve what you do. And it means that the door's already open. We're not going to be judgmental. I think that's a fair comment, yeah?
We do have one question. Addie Joy is asking, how do we get our hands on this literature?
If you're a Rogier ambassador, you can contact your relationship manager. If you work with the distributor has all the collateral available for them, for you and your salons. And when you become an Rogier ambassador, you get reward dollars. You can use those reward dollars for back bar support, for education, and also for collateral. Yeah, so we're very progressive, and we're very boutique, which I think is, and we're very personable, so I think that these are good assets for us. I think it's time to dive into the product, Lauren, so it's time for you to, lift up. Oh, there you go, you're getting taller. Let's go over to the retail wall, and just pan around here right now. So, retail is the key for us, yeah? So as we see the retail focus right here, you can see how simple and how clean, right in the window, and we'll spin this around here. This is my Brooklyn location. So you have, that's all the American Wave products. If we spin around, you can see right at the back there, there is also a product station. So we got products throughout. The retail furniture, and this, again, another unique thing, retail furniture, this is an Rogier retail shelf. Yeah, tie me lace. This is a Rogier retail shelf. You can buy this through Belvedere. We have an Rogier chair, but if you're really looking at retail, and come on over here, I want to show you how we did it. This little insert kind of is like this could be your focus point. This insert here, see this little kind of, and this moves, this comes out. So this can move, and this can be your featured product. So we designed it like that. You got the shelves underneath, which I think are good for storage. But more importantly, if you're gonna be successful at selling products, you gotta rack them and stack them. Yeah, we have a saying that if you go to the grocery store and there's 3 apples, you won't buy an apple. But if you go into the grocery store and there's a massive stack of apples and it's all pristine, that's when you buy. So you'll notice we have a lot of products on the shelf, a lot of money on the shelf, because I'm a firm believer you've got to turn this into real money. So as we're looking at this wall here, I'm going to start with my shampoos. So this is like the shampoo conditioner wall. Straight out of the gate, we have our daily shampoo. Daily shampoo is $18. This is a clear, clean, vitamin boosted, mineral rich. Typically speaking, on every product, we put the simplest of instruction right at the front, so that when anyone's actually using the product, they already know what the key component is for this product. I developed this product as my signature shampoo. Has a rhubarb fragrance. It's a clear shampoo. Let's have a look and see. You can see, so it's totally clear, colorless. It's a beautiful, lightweight, vitamin infused. It's got the rhubarb fragrance, which is kind of very British. Rhubarb's red, orojo's red. I like to sell this product to all of my male clients. I think this is a brilliant product for every guy. Yeah, because most guys have short, healthy hair. They want a nice, clean, daily wash. And anybody with shorter hair. It's a beautiful, lightweight, clean shampoo. The conditioner, the weight of the conditioner, I would say, is a lightweight conditioner. Can also be used as a leave-in conditioner. And again, has that beautiful rhubarb fragrance. So this is the entry-level shampoo at $18. And the conditioner is $20, and this can also be used as a brilliant leave-in conditioner. Next up, we're going to slowly move up. The way in which I built the product is we've got our entry-level shampoos, and then we slightly evolve into more luxury with the product too. So we've not just tried to stay in one category. We've said, let's stretch across, and you'll find that as I go through this, you're going to get more. There will be some products that are ingredient kind of heavy. We'll talk about that in a second. Next up, so your daily shampoo is a simple product to understand, moisturizing shampoo. This shampoo contains coconut oil, vitamin B5. This has a soothing, because it's moisturizing, the fragrance is berry musk. This is a moisture binder. The vitamin B5 will bind moisture to the hair shaft. It is a lightweight shampoo with moisture. You can see the pearlization of the product. So this is not clear, this is pearlized. And this has an amazing conditioner within this family. The fragrance is berry musk. All of my shampoos and conditioners all have their own unique scent, unique fragrance. The moisturizing conditioner is very rich. You can see the richness of it. But again, it still is lightweight. It has a really nice amount of slip. But this is really going to help to bind and soften the hair shaft. So who do I use this for? People with longer hair that are not color focused, hair that's healthy, medium density, not overly thick density, medium density. The thickness of this product is nice. It can really get through pretty much everybody's head of hair. So this is if a client's got slightly longer hair, she's looking for moisture. The product comes in at $19, and it comes in at $21 for the conditioner. So you got the shampoo and the conditioner, brilliant product. So that was the first two products that we developed, and we've had these products on the shelf for 10 years, and we do phenomenally well. Our best-selling shampoo is this one right here. This is Color Safe Shampoo and Color Safe Conditioner. So we went to a manufacturer that develops and creates hair color because we said we want to utilize the technology that you've understood to help protect the color deposit that's left within the hair when you color hair. So we developed Color Safe Shampoo. We kept it super simple in the name so that people understood what it was. Color Safe Shampoo to protect what you've just invested in. This is a lightweight shampoo. Has an amazing fragrance, linden blossom, which is a big feature in a Rojo product. So the third fragrance, linden blossom. This product is a beautiful pearlized, worked with a chemist personally to develop this shampoo. It's a lightweight shampoo, which means that from a viscosity standpoint, it's right in the center. It has a lot of movement within it. It's not too thick, and nor is it too skinny or too thin. It has essential proteins and again the vitamin B5, but a special color locking. It has a color locking complex that helps to not disturb, or it doesn't disturb, the color molecules that have been deposited. And we've had phenomenal results with this. As I say, it's our best-selling shampoo. The conditioner I developed when I thought about color and I thought about my clients. I've always felt like if you had a blonde who does color and she has subtle tones, if the conditioner's too heavy, you get a lot of complaints. So when I developed this conditioner, I said, let's develop the ColorSafe conditioner to be lightweight. Therefore, any fine heads, any blondes, anybody that maybe is not looking to, because you do get that complaint or that concern that the conditioner collapses the hair too much, and body's a big issue for us. So this is a lightweight conditioner, but the good news is we also have a couple of treatments that could be easily substituted in that also share the same fragrance, linden blossom, so that if you're doing a client with color, but you need something that's got more potency or more moisturizing, or you want more slip, or you want more nourishment, we've got other treatments that you can sub in, or you can kind of replace, so you can get the shampoo and maybe a treatment, and that gives you that magic. And that's one of the things with the Rogeo product too, thinking about it from the hairdresser's perspective, which is me, thinking about how I can communicate it to the clients on the salon floor. Three shampoos in, we've still got another four shampoos. We have a very extensive line, something pretty much for everybody. Next up, we have our gentle shampoo. Now, this is more ingredient focused. If you know my history and my career, we all know, and one of my mentors was a guy called Horst Reckelbacher. He created Aveda. So I wanted to create a shampoo that would appeal to those clients that are more ingredient focused. I wanted to have, you know, a product that could compete with a client that maybe is purchasing product that is organic. So we went to a special different chemist. We said, let's make an organic shampoo and conditioner so that we have that ingredient base. We never made the claim, because when I developed the brand, I said I was gonna call it Arogeo Organic, and I said, now let's just call it Arogeo Gentle Shampoo. So this has an amazing woodsy smell. It's called Fresh Verbena. It kind of just has that, as you'd imagine it, it kind of conjures up natural, earthy, green, fresh verbena. Contains avocado oil and honey. So again, great ingredients for the treatment and making there. This is sodium free, this is sulfate free, sodium chloride free. It repairs, it nourishes. It's a little skinnier as a shampoo. So when I talk about skinnier, it's definitely a little bit more on the watery side. Yeah? The reason being, it doesn't have the surfactants in the product, some of the stabilizers, because we went for a more clean and green shampoo. So it is lighter, which is a benefit, because on thick heads, this is a great product to work through the hair, because if the hair's so dense, it's hard to get that shampoo through. Extensions, this is great because it doesn't disturb. It's easy in, easy out. Even though it's sulfate and sodium lauryl free, you've got an amazing, thick, rich foam, which I always believe that when using a shampoo, you want to feel like a nice foam. So the gentle shampoo, and then of course we have, with jojoba and rosemary, we have the gentle conditioner. Again, I would call this an everyday conditioner for not really dealing with big condition issues, but if you're looking to smooth the cuticle, you're looking to add luster, softness, shine, this is the one that's gonna do it. It's not as heavyweight as some. We're gonna move into the more luxurious conditioners and shampoos in the brand as I continue to go through this journey. So, which is your favorite shampoo, Paul?
Well, I feel like for me, I'm always thinking ahead of the style.
Yeah.
So when I'm working with a client or I'm working on set or something like that, if I have to wash the hair, I'll always be looking at the product that's gonna help me with the style.
So you think that the shampoo, actually
is a part of the style.
It's a part of the style. Yeah. Okay.
Because sometimes you can. I remember years ago, people will say, "Oh, I want my hair done for a do, or should I not wash it?"
Right. Yes.
Who wants to go to a do and not wash their hair?
Exactly.
So for me, it was about like thinking about what the end result is, and then you've got a kind of range where you can kind of go, okay, if I want something slick or something smooth, something shiny, glossy, kind of like.
Do you find there's enough variation in this shampoo?
Enough variation for someone who's more creative,
yeah,
and certainly from the client perspective.
Right, gotcha.
So I feel like there's something there for every client,
uh-huh,
and certainly if I'm trying to create something for a look, I've got it covered.
You've got everything covered. Let's go on to this shelf here, because now we're going to get into a bit more specific. We're moving up the ladder in performance, and we're also moving in price. So right now, when we knew that Kerastase was in the marketplace, and we knew that consumers really liked that luxury product. Certainly it was something that was being talked about when I developed this product, and we developed this shampoo to be a more luxurious, more prestigious product. We called it Shine Lux. So it's slightly different packaging. It's more on the elegant side, because again, as I look at this, I like to think of it as this is my medium. All these different things, all these different products are like, creates texture and, you know, care. So when I was thinking about this product, I wanted it to have a high shine. I wanted to have a luxurious feel. So we came up with a product called Shine Lux. It has silver caps, so it has a little bit more of that elegance. It's less colorful, so white and silver. Fragrance wise, we created more of a perfume, so a little bit more like a fine fragrance smell. This product is, I'm gonna slowly go, you'll see this product is thicker, richer. This is now, I've gone through so many shampoos right here, and this is four different chemists. So I'm working with different chemists to create different things, because different chemists have different perspectives on how you formulate. Sulfate free, sodium laurate free. It's got essential oil within the product. It's a thick, luxurious shampoo that will create true shine. And then this conditioner is one of the conditioners that I'm the most proudest of. This product here is, my wife's a hairdresser. She's got great curly hair. My kids have curly hair. This product is spectacular. Slightly more expensive. This product comes in, the conditioner, at $27. So when you're looking for if a client can afford to go and wants a little bit more luxury, Shine Lux shampoo and conditioner. This conditioner here contains cocoa butter and keratin. So this product is spectacular. The thickness, the creaminess, the softness, the fragrance. This oozes kind of that luxurious feel within your hair. And even the packaging is an upgrade from, let's say, our entry level, which was daily. So this is for your sophisticated client that's prepared to have a little bit more luxury in her life or his life. And the conditioner, like I said, I think is an amazing formulation. And we also have, for our curly hair clients, we've created a whole curl family. In fact, you can see here, and this is kind of like the color coding. So you see anything that's this tone here. These are styling products. This is the shampoo and conditioner. Curl hydration shampoo, a little bit more luxurious grade too. It's a harder PET bottle, a little decoration. One of my hairdressers designed this for me. When we look at the design, one thing we didn't really mention, completely designed in-house, developed by hairdressers, and the hairdresser is one of a great, you know, Stephanie. Do you know, yeah, Stephanie? Yeah. She designed this product. She did the, I said I wanted something to create a little bit more of a curl pattern. So again, distinguishing it from, you know, the competition. Curl hydration shampoo, white truffle, Chardonnay grape seed, so more ingredient story here. And then the Mirabella plum oil and the earth almond in the curl hydration conditioner. So working with more natural ingredients. And this is exactly what it says it's supposed to do. It's a hydration for curly texture. So this again is a high grade, thicker shampoo, a little bit more expensive. We'll give you the price point, $25 for the shampoo and $27 for the conditioner.
We have a few questions on the shampoos.
Good.
So Danielle Cut is asking, is there a shampoo or conditioner that is nut-free? One without coconut, almond, or macadamia?
Yeah, now the best way to do that would be to look at the chart. So we can have, can you pull it off, Paul? Just pull that off that wall, that black folder there, that black, I want to show this. Now, this is what we have in our salon, and we've got an upgraded one, and we have a new one. Can you see that? Tell me if you can see that well.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is for the client, and it's also for the hairdresser. And I put this in my retail store. So let's tell you what it is. Arojo product is designed for the modern creative hairdresser, blah, 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 blah. We use high quality formulations that match your expectations for results. Consumers are now cognitive of the potential for certain cosmetic ingredients to be harmful or cause allergic reactions. This is an at-a-glance chart, highlights which Arojo products are free from certain ingredients. So right here you have cleanse, condition, style, and finish. I think you can see that, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're getting a bit of glare, a little bit of glare. Here you have sulfate-free, paraben-free, wheat-free, oat-free, sodium chloride-free, silicone-free, and we just added a new to the chart, which was gluten-free. Wheat-free's here, gluten-free.
Yeah.
And then what happens is this chart will let the client know what is or is not in each of the specific products. And even at the bottom here, you have a descriptor of what sulfate-free means, what wheat-free means, what oat-free, because a lot of people, they hear the saying, the tagline, but they don't know what it means. So we're still, with our education culture, the whole philosophy is not just education about hairdressing, it's educating the client on the right products to use. So this is what you need, Danielle, and this will help you really understand at a glance what is or is not in the product.
Gabby Mendoza is asking, how often do you recommend shampooing for men?
Oh, well, guys like to wash their hair a lot. I certainly notice that because I go to the gym pretty much every day when I'm in New York. We've got co-washes, we've got shampoos, we'll go through that. Me personally, if the guy's hair's short, I would recommend washing it every day. Yeah, and the daily shampoos are brilliant, clean, will not take away anything from that consumer. If his hair's slightly longer, then maybe I'll think about a co-wash, because maybe a little bit of, I don't need to maybe make it so squeaky clean. And really, when you use the daily shampoo, it doesn't make it squeaky clean. It cleans, but without making it feel like you've taken everything away. It's really like you just want to feel fresh, and you want your hair, especially if you're going to put a styling product in to get the finish, you want your hair hygienically and your scalp to be hygienically clean. That's some of the things that we are talking a lot about now, is scalp benefits and how to look after your scalp, and we're working on products as we consider that, because it is very much new technology when it comes to looking after your scalp. So that's for the future. I think I answered that question, yeah?
Mm-hmm. One more question.
Yes?
Sue Whittle is asking, do you have a recommendation for someone who's been ill and their hair started falling out?
Yes, I sure do. Yeah, I sure do. If you are losing your hair, hair loss typically can come with medication. Yeah, that can be a big component. I've seen clients, I've been doing hair for so many years, I've had clients that have been through all kinds of stuff. I've seen hair go from getting really thin to just getting really thick again. You'd be surprised. I would keep your hair hygienically clean and keep your scalp hygienically clean. Gentle shampoo is what I would use if you was my client. It's an easy product to put onto the scalp and into the hair, and it's an easy product to rinse out. So I would go with a gentle shampoo.
And then one more, Maria Mija is asking, where did you say you got your product shelves from again?
Oh, Belvedere. Yeah, these are the Arojo station. You can go to Belvedere. We designed it. This is the perfect type for purchasing. This is not for purchasing. No one's coming up here. This is the perfect type, 1, 2, 3. And each shelf is lit, so you have that nice soft glow. It looks nice at night. My newest shampoo, let's come over here, newest shampoo, Brassy Tones Be Gone. When you become an Arojo ambassador, you get these, you can get these. These are all part of what we call our Dropbox. Our team puts these images out every week. This is something, Lauren, that you get involved in, yeah? Mm-hmm. So you can always have collateral and merchandising in your salons. We always send, you can get these very inexpensive plastic folders. They're clean, minimal, and professional. And we like to change these every week. Yeah, so it's a great tool to create creativity within the brand. So Brassy Challenge Begun, we worked with our color department, our color team to develop, and again, we worked with a company that makes hair color, because we wanted to create a shampoo. We called it Ultraviolet. This is for those brassy tones. You can see the depth in the color in this product. See how rich that is? This was developed with our leading colorist. In Arosia, we specialize. So our cutters, we have cutters and we have colorists, yeah? So when we specialize, it means that we really have specialists within the field. Our color team really, you know, they asked for this for a long time. And eventually we managed to come good. And I actually love the label. I don't know if you can pick that label up. Yeah. It's kind of like got that little...
Ombre.
Yeah. Ombre, baby. And then here you have the conditioner. Yeah. So again, hydrolyzed keratin within the products. This is really about performance and color. And if you go on our social channels, you'll be able to see a video that was done so you can see the true effects of how it neutralizes the brass. And it's very potent and very powerful. Okay, so that was 7 shampoos, 7 conditioners. That's a lot, and we're just getting started.
One more question on shampoo and conditioner.
Yeah, let's do it.
Addie Joy is asking, what shampoo and conditioner is going to be best for someone looking for thickening and volume?
That's a great question. For me personally, I would go with Shine Luxe shampoo or moisturizing. That would be my two choices. The Shine Luxe shampoo is really good because not only is it thick, but it does create a lot of cleansing, which really gives it that, like, it gives you the ability then to kind of remove any products that may have built up in the hair. That's why the conditioner in Shine Luxe is so spectacular, because really it is a family that needs to be worked together. Moisturizing, you're gonna get a similar effect, but it's a lighter, and when it's a lighter kind of formulation, and the more expensive a product is, it's based on the amount of raw material that's put in the product. So when it gets more expensive, it's because we're putting more of the active ingredients and a higher concentration of them in the product, so you do get to see the benefit of that. So I would say Shine Luxe shampoo and conditioner or moisturizing shampoo and conditioner. Awesome. Treatments. So now we've got the 7 shampoos, 7 conditioners. I got 2 treatments right here. Both brilliant. I love that. This is one of my favorite products. This is called Whipped Treatment. I'll take it. Is that a good shot?
Yeah.
Olive oil and shea butter. This is a, I was in a show, a woman said to me, she said to me, how do you use this product? I said, well, you put it in, yeah? You squeeze it in the shower. It's a treatment, so it's a heavyweight conditioner. I like to call this a moisture punch. Olive oil and shea butter, so 2 great call-out ingredients, kind of create the great connotation. This is thick, this is moisturizing. She said to me, how'd you use it? I said, you put it in like a conditioner, work it through, leave it in. If you want to have it as a treatment, you can leave it on for 10 or 15 minutes. It will really penetrate the cuticle and get a beautiful softness, so it's a real moisture punch. And then you rinse it out. And she said, oh, you rinsed it out? I said, yeah. She said, oh, and then her husband walked up and he went, I've got whipped treatment in my hair. I'm like, you've not rinsed it out? He went, no. I said, okay. God bless if she's tuning in. I said, Yogi, he said, I'll just do anything my wife tells me, you know, hairdresser. So whipped treatment, olive oil, shea butter. This is also a color locking formulation, $28. $28, that's a huge size. Look at the size of this can. It's innovative, it comes out like a whip. So that's why we call this Whipped Treatment. And it's a color locking formulation. So it's great for those clients that you want to lock in that fashion tone, you want to lock in that pastel. You cannot go wrong with this product. If there's one thing you should try, well, I shouldn't say that because I'll say that over and over again. And then the other one we have is Hair Repair Treatment. Hair Repair Treatment contains keratin and quinoa. The nice thing about this, this is a protein-rich mask. This is more moisture, this is more strength. So when you're talking moisture, you're talking whip treatment. When you're talking structure and strength, hair repair. Hair repair treatment, whipped treatment. So they're both rinse out products, and they're the two different treatments, and they both have the same fragrance as the ColorSave. Because you may say to your client, you know what, get the ColorSave shampoo, but I need you with a thicker, heavier weight moisture punch with the whip treatment, or I need you to get more structure and more strength. They'll both soften. This has more moisture, this has more strengthening. So you can kind of tailor the product offering, which is certainly something that we thought about. We thought about personalization when we come to developing products. That's why we have such an extensive range.
We have a question. Yep. Samantha Maria is asking, is the toning shampoo really strong, or is it gentle enough for daily toning?
Oh, well, you know what? That's a great question, you know? And I think, Lauren, what I'd like you to do is I'd like you to do a survey with our colorists on Orojo Social.
Okay.
And let's get some direct feedback from our colorists. The depth of this product is going to give you pretty strong results. Yeah? This definitely is a... Zach... Come on in. I got Zach. We're lucky. He just came in. We got Zach, our team lead
just
here.
In time.
He's our color master.
Hi, guys.
What was the question? The question was,
is the toning shampoo really strong, or is it gentle enough for daily toning?
You know what? The great part about the ultraviolet is it is strong enough to counterbalance all of those yellow tones, but it doesn't overdeposit. What it does is it has a blue violet, so it will even help to kind of counterbalance any some of those kind of over oxidized goldeny tones, but it's not going to over deposit, which is a really great thing because it's more user friendly for our clients to send home. I recommend they using it about every week to every other week because it will last so long, and the product is really, really strong, but not too strong that it will make it too dingy, too dark, or too matte.
Good job, I got the master here, thanks. I couldn't have said it better myself. Yeah, can't see that? We pulled him in, just for you and that question.
We got low battery.
Low battery, let's get the plug, let's charge it up, bring it over, we'll have to get to a place where we can get a plug, because we don't want to...
Do we have an extension cord?
Yeah, we'll find it. It's right there, Paul, thanks. Zach, do you have an extension cord in the house?
Yeah.
Great.
We have another question.
Great.
Rachel Barrel is asking, will you develop shampoos for scalp conditions like dandruff or density issues?
This is a good... My good friend Karen Gordon is a hair loss specialist. So as it happens, even this morning, we were having conversations about products and hair loss and what we can use. And we're testing stuff all the time. So watch the space and see how we grow. For me, this is like a labor of love. This is my lifestyle. So I think you're going to see some things happen in that category too. I think my product line in general right now, we're at approximately 50 products, is pretty much, we pretty much filled every hole. So now what we're doing is we're looking where there are holes or where there is an opportunity for us to maybe add. But I'm not the kind of company that just adds so that I can increase sales. It's got to be value. I need value. Oh, very good. You're getting power, Lauren. Right. Shall we move on?
Yep.
So we've gone through all of the cleansing and all of the conditioning. What I'd like to do now is go to the first thing out of the backwash. You bring your client over, and I got this great product here. Paul, I've been talking a lot. I'm going to bring you in. What about this Hydro Mist? You use this product?
Yeah, a lot.
And what is it, and why would
I feel like it's a product that covers so many different things.
Mm-hmm.
Because you've got a lot of people using it just like coming from the hair. People don't want to use too much product in their hair. They're kind of using it to hydrate the ends, so you can be really like direct where you're putting it.
Uh-huh.
But then you have a lot of stylists using it as almost like a cutting tool.
It's a cutting tool, yeah. They do. Yeah.
So it kind of covers a lot. And I feel like it's the product that's used like with every client.
Mm-hmm. It is. I use it on every client. Straight from the backwash, I use this product. Look at the spray. The spray is incredibly light. So it's not a very heavy, wet spray, which is really good for when you're cutting. Has an amazing fragrance, so straight away you send your client on a sensory journey. I sell this product to my client as a resetter. So when you want to replenish, reset, re-wet, curly hair texture, you don't want to wet the hair down, you want to, like, you don't want to wash the hair, you can maybe just reset the curl, you could reset your bang. I sell this product also to clients for their kids. I got kids with curly hair, you just layer this in. You don't wanna maybe put mousses or gels into young people's hair, you know, especially when they're so young. You know, you're talking about the, you know, 8 and under. You can use this as a detangler. It's a detangling lightweight conditioning spray and we sell it for $20. Brilliant product. I could spray all this on one client, it won't make the hair greasy. But what it will do is it'll make the hair have shine and it will also balance out the porosity within the hair shaft. And as Paul said, a lot of the hairdressers use it as a cutting lotion. You don't want to wet the hair down too much. We're known for our razor cutting. It's a great tool to work in conjunction when you're working with your razor. So this is a foundation spray and a conditioning spray, and it has a delicious fragrance, which I think is important because it kind of gets that client in the journey of, oh God, this is different. And I'm really into that. I think most times, the reason why hairdressers don't do well with retail, oh, and by the way, Zach, you did great this week, and Andrea did great with the retail in the salon, phenomenal, here in Brooklyn, they really knocked it out of the park. They don't do so well is because we wait till the end. So part of our journey is we like to involve products right the way through the whole experience. So from the minute the client comes in, the shampoo, there's interaction on the product when they come back from the backwash, there's interaction on the product, there's an application of a new product, Hydro Mist, and it keeps consistency. By the time the client comes to checkout, she's already had and answered all of the questions, or she's had all the questions answered, because we've not waited till the final minute, yeah. All right, so the way in which we design it, so we had cleanse and we had condition, and now we're gonna start to work on foundation and style. And I think, Paul, you're gonna be helping me over here. Let's have a look, how does the light work here with that with that window? Not so great?
It's okay.
It's okay. Well, Paul, volume foam. These are like our bodybuilders, so yeah. Volume foam. Let's talk a little bit about that.
So for me, volume foam is a real performance product. I can really layer this on the hair. It's a pump. Ooh, you froze it. It's a pump rather than like a foam, like an aerosol. But for me, I can put more than you actually think you're gonna put on. Like I'm gonna use some of this.
Yeah, go for it.
You know, I'm using kind of like this amount. And then I'll lay that in. Sometimes I'll rough dry that in or dry that in, and then I can layer it again. It really allows me to kind of build up a texture. Mm-hmm. And then when I go in with my styling tools, whatever that may be, maybe a brush or even just drying it with my hands, I'm really like laying down a really good foundation to be able to build up a shape or build up someone's finer hair or even medium hair. I still want to give it that like luxury kind of heaviness.
So it gives it a volumizing, a thickness.
No stickiness. No, absolutely no stickiness. I think there's been a thing of foam or mousse, as they used to call it.
Yep.
You know, people are afraid of that. It's associated with a time.
Right.
Well, I feel like this is a modern foam that gives you all that without that old fashioned crunch.
Right.
Or stickiness.
Yep. Well, this is what we did when I met with the chemist. Yeah, you got to go and throw it away, yeah? When I met with the chemist, I said, listen, I used to have an Aveda concept salon. I used to do a lot of work for Aveda, yeah? So, and I met with my chemist. I said, I want to make a foam that is that's going to be a bodybuilder. And I said, listen, this is what we'll do. Let's take Formolian, which is the Aveda foam, and let's take the Phyto Volume Spray, which I also really liked because I thought that was a great product for building texture. And I said, let's make a product. If those two products had a baby, and this is it. This is the baby.
It's not even tacky in the hair.
Not tacky in the hand.
No, not tacky in the hair. And like I say, you can apply and reapply.
Right.
I think it's like a product that everybody could use.
And now you've used a lot because you've done a lot of classes on this product, yeah?
When you're doing on set or you're doing a shoot, you really want to be able to trust in a product.
Uh-huh.
You know, if I have to make someone's hair big, you know, I want to be able to lay a product that's not going to flake, it's not going to go sticky, it's going to be workable, I can put heat on it,
yeah.
It's not going to smoke. So it was a product I could just keep working and working and working without losing control or losing the texture. So rework it all the time. So it's very workable. And actually, it's a product that if someone doesn't like to blow dry their hair, put it in, let it dry, and as they kind of move their hair around during the day, it's just going to fat it up. Yeah.
Well, you know, my mum's from Scotland, and she's got that European, Scottish, like four strands, you know, one here, one here, one here, one here.
So I made,
so I made this product for my mother, and when she you know, she came back from this, she said, oh, I love it, dear. I love it, I love it. I'm happy, mum. Volume foam, amazing product. The chemist that developed this product for me left the company that he was working for when we developed the product. This is a little bit of useless information. And I found him, and I went to another manufacturer, and I went and chased him because, you know, when you're making product like anything, you meet these chemists, and some chemists are just, they understand it or they understand you. The chemist that developed the volume foam for us really did a spectacular job. So that's a volumizer. We have a couple of other volumizers. We do have, well, stay in this, because these we call whips. Yeah? So we have, which I suppose is, again, that, you know, kind of moussified.
Yeah.
Do you know what, Paul? Why don't you grab me two of these from the from the counter? So I want to spray them. I want to show you. So these two are whips. So these are both predominantly to put into wet hair. Styling whip is our argon infused. Argon is one of the most nutritious you know, ingredients out there for the hair and scalp. And Moroccan oil, we all know, was a very big product, and it was huge 6 years ago. And I said, you know, Rojo product, we need to have an argon-based product to compete. So we came out with Styling Whip. This is what we call a does-it-all styler because of the argan oil, it kind of conditions, styles, because it comes out in a whip, it creates hold, creates volume, so it has a volumizing agent, it has a active agent to help with the health and the shine. You've got the oil, but with the volume, which is amazing. And then this cream whip is a whipped cream that comes out creamier than the creamier than this foam, than the styling whip. The whipped cream is kind of like if you're doing that natural dry and you want to really add like a lightweight but a lot of slip.
Luxury, kind of.
Luxurious, kind of natural. Yeah. Let me just, I'm going to show you. I'll just put both in my hand at the same, I'll put both in. So there's the whip, and you're going to see the difference. And there's the cream. So you'll see, if you look at the, I don't know how well this picks up, but if I, you'll see the bubbles are starting to come. See the bubbles are starting to come in this?
Yeah.
What happens is this now is gonna go from that whip, it's gonna go into an oil. So it has a slip to it, which is it's disappearing now into the argan oil. So the argan oil is now, and it's a great way to deliver this product because it's a lightweight whip. You put it through the hair, it's beautiful. You can see now it's just turned to oil. Now, look at this product. This one hasn't disappeared, hasn't dissipated. This is the cream whip. So the cream whip is like a luxury, creamy conditioning whip. One is argan infused. The other is more about softness, suppleness, condition. And is there anything that I kind of missed on that, Paul?
Sometimes, you know, you get the client that wants the blowout, but they don't want any product.
Right.
So it's more in this line with the conditioning.
Uh-huh.
So you're giving the client the performance of a great blow dry. It's making it look polished, shiny, luxury, without them feeling like there's product in their hair, which is quite a nice.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
Light fragrances on both of those products. Linda, we used our lavender pear is in a lot of our styling products. So while we have individual fragrances for the shampoos and the conditioners, when it comes to styling, we have very limited change in fragrance. Because I'm a firm believer that when you're layering, you don't want to have candy flavors and clashing flavors, you know, fragrances in your hair, especially now where we are so focused on fragrance. So lavender pear, nice and light, it just smells clean and fresh. So there are three bodybuilders. We have two blow dry lotions. We have our protective thickening lotion, And the descriptions on these are exactly what they're supposed to be. Descriptions, protective, thickening, lotion. And then we also have a set and style spray. So protective thickening lotion is gonna protect, it's gonna prevent breakage, it's going to protect from the heat, it's gonna add thickness, it comes as a spray. It's got a different feel and finish to the volume foam. The volume foam's gonna kind of pad the hair out from the inside. The protective thickening lotion is gonna give the hair a little bit more structure with protection. And then the set and style spray is a lightweight setting or blow dry lotion. So if you want hair to swing, you just want a nice shine, you don't want the hair to feel heavy or weighty, both this spray here is your set and style. Also great if you're on set or if your client uses rollers, she wants to have a lightweight setting lotion, this is your set and style spray. What did I miss?
Well, everyone now is using a curling iron or a wand or, you know, trying to get that beachy wave.
Yeah.
Perfect product.
Perfect product. Next up, let's go. So we're still kind of, this is all kind of our wet. This is like we're traditionally kind of applying this stuff now as a foundation for the blow dry. Another topic that is big is frizz. So we have what I call a high grade silicone. This is a high quality, high grade silicone. It's a defrizz serum. This is an amazing product because it collapses the cuticle. Makes the hair skinny, puts the hair on a diet. If you have thick, coarse, curly hair and you want to compress it, this is the product. This product will also diminish flyaways. It prevents static. So again, tame static, smooths hair, defrizz serum, high grade. A little goes a long way. The size of a dime on a thick head of hair is going to be more than enough. This is a silicone. This is Shine Lux oil. Not a silicone. So a silicone coats the hair and changes the appearance of it. The Shine Lux oil penetrates the hair. This is, we like to say, skincare technology meet hair care. So this contains HYA. HYA is a moisture binder. It binds moisture actively throughout the day, so it draws the moisture into the hair shaft. This can be used on wet or dry hair. It's a precious oil. It's a combination of different oils. So what happens is this comes out in a small, it's got like a little dropper, so it's a little bit more like a skincare feel. It's a more expensive product. This product comes in at $26. So it's a much smaller size, but this is high grade and sits with the Shine Lux family. This product here, this is your workhorse defrizz serum. This, I would not put this into dry hair, because when you put it into dry hair, it will kind of absorb the atmosphere. Put it into wet hair, compress the hair, flatten the hair. This is also great for ethnic clients, clients that are maybe have natural texture or afro texture or very thick, coarse, curly texture. This is a great product because then you smooth that hair out and this will aid in the smoothing. Then you're gonna have a clean finish, not a sticky finish and not a kind of like a lank finish. Anything else to add, Paul?
The Shine Lux, I feel like it's more like a cosmetic product.
Cosmetic.
So yeah. It's more like I had a client this week, and I was saying to her, just put it in your handbag. Don't leave it at home.
Yeah.
So it's something you can just like a little pump during the day, just add to the men. She had really long hair. It becomes like you put a lip balm on or a face cream.
There you go.
You just kind of add it to your hair as you go. And if you're kind of in the office, get the air conditioning, it gets a bit fluffy. It's a tiny little amount, and you just kind of.
And it won't make the hair oily. It will not overweigh the hair down. No. It's a lightweight, you know, take that product, put a little bit in your skin, you'll see it'll just disappear in. So I think that's a great concept.
It's kind of more like put it in your handbag kind of thing rather than in your bathroom cabinet.
And that's part of like what this ambassador thing is as well. Yeah, we're giving you real life situations where hairdressers, we're sharing kind of, because I teach all the time, I say, it's all about the words that you use. If you hit the sweet spot with the right word, then the client opens up to you and she starts to believe in you and she trusts you. And when she trusts you, then you're kind of gonna have that loyalty and that's how you build your business. Let's have a look and see. So traditionally what we just went through is like our foundation products, but there's plenty more stuff to do. Paul's just picked up this product here, Wave Mist.
Yeah, to me it's a foundation product as well. You know, this is going to give us more texture. It's going to give a little bit more grittiness in there. You know, we call it wave mist, but I've been using it on guys a lot.
Yeah.
I've been using it on short hair a lot. It helps me build up that foundation texture before I might even use like a wax or a cream to finish a look. So, or straight into that person that doesn't even want to blow dry their hair.
So this product was designed as a kind of our answer to a beach wave spray.
Yeah.
Does it have a grit to it, or is it light without that kind of... Can you feel salt in there?
Well, there's certain products that overload.
Yeah.
So then once it's in there, there's no like movement.
Uh-huh.
It fixes the hair. Whereas this, I feel like, kind of gives you that more natural kind of like little bit of grittiness, but it feels like still believable, feels like yours, still touchable, still very workable.
Doesn't have a gritty feel in the hand?
No, it doesn't overload like I have with some
other
like,
products.
Yeah,
I got you. Because that's been a big category, the wave sprays. A big category.
It's like you either love it or you hate it.
Right.
Whereas I feel like this, you can't hate it because it doesn't take you to that point.
Gotcha. And this has just a different handle.
Yeah.
So again, the handle's talking to the client because it's saying, I've got a trigger, which means you can use it like a water spray. This also has a little locking mechanism. And again, this product, I believe, is a price point. It's about $24. $24, I believe.
And the humidity is great with the humidity.
Yeah.
Because it stops everything down.
So it kind of keeps it together and doesn't kill the...
Doesn't kill. So guys, it's a good little prep product. People with short hair, it's good. But people who don't want to blow dry their hair.
Gotcha.
Used it this morning.
You used it this morning?
Yeah.
Good job, Lauren.
So let's have a feel.
Okay, let's move over now into more of our creams and our tubes. So we come up with creams and pastes and tubes and gels, all in these tubes. I'm going to go first to our styling cream. I talk about my product being relatively soft in hold across the board. If you're looking for a little bit more grip, you're looking for a little bit of a stronger hold, styling cream is, I think of this as like a foundation to putting a lot more structure into there. This is a cream liquid gel. It's a white product. It comes out white in your hand. The density and the consistency of it is very movable. Has a lot of slip, but as it dries, it kind of has a little bit more of a lock.
Yeah, you get the lock.
What would you, anything else, Paul, for this? How would you use this product?
For me, again, if I just want a little bit more hold, or I'm trying to hold a style or kind of make sure something stays there, that's going to give you that little bit of...
So that's the styling cream, phenomenal product. I like that. Again, I like to put that in more wet. Now we're going to move into some of these other creams. Let's stay on the top shelf, yeah? And look at these. All these tubes are $23. So you have hair cream, styling cream, frizz control. Hair cream is creates smoothness and polish. This is for natural separation. This is a hair groomer. So this is a lightweight grooming cream. It's actually designed to work well as well for silver hair, which can be kind of like unruly. So gray hair that kind of, and remember that there's a lot of hair that's gray that's colored. So this has a special emollient within it that helps to work on coaxing or encouraging smoothness and softness. It's a great hair, lightweight hair groomer. And the frizz control is different from the defrizz serum because this is a frizz controlling cream. So it has more of the oil finish within the product. A little bit more heavyweight. This is light. This has a little bit more of a defrizzing, or more of a humectant type feel. If you blow dry this product into the hair, and you can, it's gonna be a little bit smokier, and it's gonna leave the hair a little bit more languid. Not gonna be so clean. If you use defrizz serum, you get that swingy clean. If you use frizz control cream, you'll get that kind of like day two clean and day two finish. Anything else?
Well, if you've got a really dense texture of hair and you want to lay it flat, so even like if you're blowing out like an afro straight, afro texture, you know, if you're going with that, it's going to help lay. Sometimes if you blow dry a product, like with a product, the hair will start to kind of lift up right? Especially with a bit of humidity, will that all keep it laid down and give you that bit more security that that hair is going to
stay? It's going to stay down.
Yeah.
We're going down onto the bottom shelf. We got one of our new products here, which I can't wait to talk about. But let's talk about some of our classics and some of the first products that we did. Hair gel. This is our strongest hold product that we have. Well, maybe not now because we have the clay, which I think is pretty strong too in a different way. But this is a classic hair gel designed realistically for the, really for the guy in mind. So this is for a guy that's looking for hold, control, someone that is really looking for a gel. I have lots of clients that are looking for a gel. They want a gelled look, they want a PC look, but they want it to be hold. I have a lot of Asian clients that their hair grows this way, but they want their hair to go that way. The hold in this product is spectacular. This product comes out clear, so it's completely clear too. No residue, no flaking. I worked with this product with one of my clients. I've been doing his hair for over 25 years, and I like to call him a gel master because he knows gel more than anyone else I know. And together we worked on this product, and it's a clear, non-flaking, super strong, clean hair gel with the rhubarb fragrance, just like the daily shampoo. I think we got it, yeah? And then our texture paste, which is one of my favorites. In fact, I have texture paste in my hair today. If I don't put products in my hair is just like a wet grass. Just lies there flat, nothing, it's horrible. So to create this kind of texture, my hair is clean, and my hair is quite fine. In fact, it's very fine. And it's weaved in from about here up.
It's yours?
Yeah, no, I borrowed it. keep it down. So texture paste, we're actually testing a new formulation for it right now, which is something that we do with the products all the time. We're always trying to improve the product, so we're constantly relooking. Flexible hold, more of a matte finish. It's a texturizing paste. It's better to put in when the hair's wet. I like to put it in when the hair's wet. It goes in, you can have pliable, movie, messy texture. And it's a classic texture paste. Again, $23. The gel, $23. Now we do have fiber, which is something, Paul, that you tested a lot with us, and
yep.
You got the seal of, you gave this one the seal of your approval. So, what is fiber?
Well, for me, it kind of makes, it gives it like a bit of elasticity.
Yeah, so it's got a little bit of a...
Yeah, it's got a bit of stretch in there, which is nice.
Yeah.
But you can use it on the guy that just wants a little bit of product in there, that doesn't want to, obviously doesn't blow dry the hair. But I was actually starting to work it into wet, curly hair and just letting it dry, air dry, and then running your hands through it. It wasn't like frizzing. You could move the hair around, you could pull it, you could stretch it out.
So it has hold, but it has flexibility.
It has flexibility.
Does it have residue, or does it kind of feel very clean in there?
It feels clean in there.
Yeah, because the texture paste feels like you've got a little bit of something in there, whereas this is more lightweight.
It kind of feels like it gets absorbed, but it keeps like a cleanness and a flexibility in the hair, and like pliable would be a word I would use.
And this product we designed, it's kind of, if you know, it's the kind of product that when you work your hands together, you'll get like just a very fine like webbing.
Yeah.
Is that what you call that?
Yeah.
Like, you'll see it's got just that little bit, that's that stretch, I suppose, that goes in the hair.
Like the little fibers.
Little fibers. Sorry, thanks, mate. Takes me a while. So, check this out. It's $25, it's a little bit more expensive. This is a new manufacturer that I met and started working with. It's a brand new product. It came out this year. It's become a hero. We also came out with, and because we just started a barbering program, we kind of have curated like some great products for guys, and fiber certainly is one of them.
I like the fact that they all cross over.
Yeah, there's a crossover for male and female.
Yeah, there's no like kind of.
And there's a new term now, isn't there? You can be male, female, and non-specific.
Non-binary.
What's it called?
Non-binary.
Non-binary. Yeah, my product's very non-binary friendly. Clay. So again, this is just another piece of that advertised. These are the things that you can get for your stores. Scented with lemon zest and mandarin, sulfate, paraben, wheat, silicone, sodium chloride, free. What's in it? Nothing in it. It's just empty.
it works.
So Clay, this is unique, Paul.
Yeah.
I think it's a little, it's so new, we still have a long way to really educate the market with this, I think, and our hairdressers.
The funny thing is, I think this is one of the products that's just, like, it's a no-brainer. If you've got, like, even if you've got, like, jaw-length hair and you just want a bit of dry texture in there, it's great. You know, me, I use it.
Yeah,
this is my.
So that keeps your hair up like that. Yeah,
in this humidity. You know, like for me, finding that dry texture, slightly more masculine.
Yeah.
You know, for me, that for the work that we put into that, I think this come out amazing.
It's got a lot of support. It was when we developed this product and fiber originally, we tried to get them in. They wanted them in pots. But we decided that we wanted them to be in tubes because we like the idea of the like not being able to.
It has the hole, but it doesn't have the like. It's not fixed.
Right.
And when it, when you work it into the hair, I generally put it on like towel dry, like almost dry hair.
Uh-huh.
You know, so it kind of like.
Does it thicken the hair?
Thickens the hair.
Makes the hair feel thicker.
100%. Actually, you know, from a guy's point of view, and even on thick hair though, it will hold it in place.
Right.
As well.
Gotcha.
You know, I've got a few clients that have got really thick hair and doing that kind of really clean barbered look,
uh-huh.
and they want something to hold it. It's going to do that as well without the shine.
No shine, matte finish. Again, a lot of this stuff's all on the label, guys, so firm hold, matte finish. We try and keep it super simple so that, because I don't know, it's dead easy to say, oh, all the products do everything, but I think if you keep it super simple, then you know exactly what you're going to get.
And you learn
performance based.
And you learn fast as a stylist.
Yes, you do. Tubes. Okay, so we've got more tubes. Three core products. When we started a Rojo product, and they're all slightly different, although they all have the same color. When we started a Rojo product, we had one product called Curl Cream. We split it up into three categories. Curl Definer, for definition of the curl, it's a liquid gel. Curl Enhancer, to enhance the curl, it's gonna tighten and unite the curls. And then we have Curl Control, which is a controller. So, mid-weight controller, if you've got curly hair, you wanna control it, you go with the control. If you've got fine or thick hair, but you wanna encourage the curl, go with the enhancer. And if you're looking for more of a cleaner, definition, go with the Curl Definer. Every one of these products is $23. I do talk price a lot because I want hairdressers to tell clients how much the product costs as they use it. That way the client knows what the investment is if they decide to invest in what you've used. So I think we've got the curl category pretty well covered. Obviously you're right here, so you can see all color coded as a family because it's all for the curl product. And you have a clear tube with a clear cap in a white product. You have an opaque tube and you have a clear tube with a clear product. So kind of easily identified when it comes to choosing the right products for your curl. Let's keep moving. I think that we now need to get into some of our more sprays. So let's first off talk about two of our early adapters, Shine Spray. But I like to spray this product. This is a high gloss sparkle. I like to spray this into the hand. This is our non-aerosol Shine Spray and our non-aerosol Holding Spray. These were our two early adapters. Here comes New York.
Really?
That's what they were drilling there last, like, now they're gonna drill the whole street again. Look, they filled it and they're gonna drill it again.
It's the last one.
Gas leak. Hopefully you can still hear us. Holding spray, shine spray.
Oh my God.
I'm gonna keep moving. Right, let's go over there, yeah? I'm gonna grab these products because I got a couple. Let's go over to the other side, away from the, go to the back. Let's walk through the salon.
Jesus Christ. You want to go in the back corner?
Back. Oh, guys, show everybody this. That is our retail. This is an Orojo designed. This is the Orojo car. You'll notice how it's on wheels. You'll notice how it has these dividers. Made by Belvedere. Super robust. We designed this, so you've got all your products in there. They don't fall over. You have a hook here for your mirror. Either side for your mirrors. Then you have your brushes, your brush drawer. The brushes in the drawers. And then you also have your either your towel dispensary or your garbage.
They said they could still hear us.
Good, good. All right, come on over a little bit. Let's go into these sprays. Oh, dry shampoo. It's a bit of a hero for us, yeah? Yeah.
For me, I feel like this is kind of like everybody has a can now.
Everybody has a can.
Everybody has a can now. It's one of them products that, you know, it's become a bit of a cult.
Yep.
Become a cult. But I feel like some of them are building up too much. You see the whiteness, the flakiness, stuff like that. This is performs brilliantly, gives you the texture, it gives you that little bit of volume, but you're not getting any of that kind of
residue.
Exactly. Yeah.
And it also comes in a mini travel size.
Another handbag.
So another handbag. Yeah, I put this one in my handbag too. So I refinished dry shampoo. Just pass me that can. The best thing I think about this product, guys, look at the size of it. It's $29. Look at the size. This is a 300ml fill. And this for sure has been one of our heroes products. Fragrance.
People love it.
People absolutely love the fragrance on this product. Yeah. Have a workable spray. We have a brand new formulation coming out later on this year. It's been reworked. We worked with this. This is called Primp. This is our black and gold working spray. So we call it Primp. It's for primping, styling, quaffing, fast drying, humidity defense. What kind of hold does this have, Paul?
Well, for me, the job that I do, this is kind of one of, this has been my hero product for a long time. You know, this is a product I can reapply, very brushable. It's gonna give me hold, but I can still brush the hair. It's not gonna fix it. You know, I don't like to say the word Elnet, but Elnet for me was a hero product.
Yeah.
And I've swapped to this. So it's kind of replaced that for me.
Yep.
And it's something that, it's a good old fashioned kind of great product that will always be.
Well, Elnet is a European, it's a global hero. The European hairdresser and Elnet is like, and every fashion week, what would you find backstage?
Probably Elnet with black tape around it.
So when we developed that product,
yeah,
we went after that level, yeah, of performance and that level of
luxury. Like, I can even like, I think when we tested this, I put nearly a can on one person.
You did?
Kept brushing it, so it's fanning out, but just to push it to that limit of,
yeah,
how much I could use,
yeah,
without it being like sticky or unworkable. Now, workable hairspray needs to be workable, and if you put heat on it, you're not going to get that smoky kind of, it's just going to hold, it's going to hold the style.
Okay, another hairspray. What's this? It's called Fierce. This is our Fierce Firm Hold Hairspray.
It's gonna any style you put there and you want it to stay, it's gonna fix it, it's gonna give you that performance of hold. You know, it's less workable. It is workable, but it's a lot less workable, and it's really gonna give you that security that's gonna stay.
This product was one of our newest products. It took us a long time to find a strong hold hairspray that we felt didn't have that lacquered feel, but had that hold and control. Very hard product to do. So this is kind of one of our newest products, and I think we've done a phenomenal job with it. And yeah, if you're looking for a gravity-defying, wind-protecting, you know, maybe Donald needs this for when he's getting off the plane, Air Force One, this is your stronghold hairspray. And look what it says on the bottle. Firm hold hairspray, that's what it is. Unique products now, two unique ones as we're getting towards the end of the overall Orojo product. We have dry shampoo, dry conditioner.
Yeah.
How would you describe this product, Paul? It's an aerosol product, but it's a dry conditioner.
Well, for me, there was people that rebelled against the dry shampoo a little bit, and they felt it left that residue, which ours doesn't.
Yeah.
But this was giving a conditioning element as well. So if you've got somebody that wants their blow dry or their hair, they want to wash their hair for like a week, 5 days, not only are you putting like a dry shampoo texture in it, but you're conditioning at the same time. So it kind of makes the hair always look polished.
So great, I love this product. This is great for beachy blondes.
Yeah.
This is hydrolyzed keratin, so it's a strengthener, it's a conditioner, not a shine spray. If you think about dry shampoo maybe as dry cleaning your hair, think about dry conditioner as maybe putting that fabric towelette in your dryer so it makes your laundry smell great, softer, less creases. This is a calmer product. It calms the hair down. Great for those beachy blondes. If there's frizzy in the during the day, you can spray this in. It will not give shine, but it will create silkiness. So it's not a shine spray, it's a silkiness.
Very touchable.
Very touchable and a very clean, like kind of refreshing fragrance. It's like, I've just cleansed my hair. And then this is kind of like a bit of a sleeping hero. Do you use this a lot, healing oil?
It's funny because if I do a blowout and I start to get a few of them little kind of, I kind of almost like mist it in the air above, and it just kind of comes down, it lays in little flyaways down. Or if I've got someone with a real dry texture, you know, it's something I can even re-blow dry with it as well.
Yeah.
I can go over the top layer and really lay it down and get a really nice finish. It makes hair feel expensive, luxury. That dry, coarse hair, it's going to make it feel like manageable, workable.
It does have the same fragrance as the Shine Lux shampoo and conditioner, so it has that luxury. This is what I like about this product. Speeds up the blow dry, it's a glossing spray, it's a sunscreen, it's a heat protector, it's great for pressing the hair. So this product is going to give you, if you're doing a fashion tone and you're going to pre-lighten the hair and then you're going to deposit or do like a vivid or you're going to do a pastel, this product's going to give you that extra glisten, that extra slip, and also the protection. So pretty awesome product. That's a marathon, Paul. It's like almost an hour, it's over an hour and a half, we're done.
We have a few questions.
Questions?
Kelly.
Yeah. What are they drilling?
That's the dentist.
Oh gosh. Kelly Burmister is asking, so your styling products have a lavender scent?
Some of the styling products have. When we created fragrance, what happens is when you develop product, you go to you find contract manufacturers, they develop your formulation. And then you have a perfume house, a fragrance house that develops your fragrances. And one of the fragrances that we created is a lavender pear fragrance. Two variations of it. I would say it's in 80% of all of the styling products.
Okay, and then Danielle Cutt is asking Paul, what styling products are in your hair?
Clay. So kind of that's one of the new products we used. Like I said, it's not a guy's product, but it kind of works. It gives you that texture, gives you that volume, gives you that little bit of grip, gives me a matte finish is what I like. You know, so it's got the hold without feeling like stiff and stuck.
Okay. And then Scott Hare is asking, how do those products work for people that live in warm climate or people that go to the gym after work? Some men's products bother my eyes.
Well, I think that, you know what? We sell the products in all over America. And I'm very active talking to my hairdressers. I do know the different climates. I also have a place in Florida. I've got a very successful salon in Florida called Visions. I have a number of great salons, but one to call out is one of my flagship salons, Visions. So it doesn't get much hotter than in Florida. So we find that the products work fantastic there. In California, it's the dry heat. You'll tend to find that there's no challenges with the products there. Again, because we have such a nice diverse range, you're gonna find the products that work well for your particular climate. And it's something that we definitely address as we develop and work with products. And I've been through the products with you right now. But what I'm going to tell you is we've had this for 10 years. So we've evolved over 10 years and we constantly are looking to innovate and improve. Even though the product might be called the same thing, it may be an enhanced improved formulation based on what we find in the marketplace. And we're working in with the products every single day. Anything else?
That's it for the questions.
Well, you know what I think we're going to do? I think we're going to wrap it up because American Wave is a secondary product line that we have, and I'm going to pause on American Wave and do that for you in 2 weeks from now because I think that we need to spend more focus and time. When you carry American Wave, you're also connected to my culture and to my vision. So I'm a firm believer that we'll come back in 2 weeks and we'll give you the overview on American Wave hair care and the reinvention of what we used to call the perm, the American Wave service. I hope that today's been a big help. I want to thank Paul for being here.
Amazing.
Doing a great job. We're going to be sharing more of our video product. We're going to be videoing our product on IGTV. It's something you're going to see happen. Lauren's got the task for that. So over the coming months, you're going to constantly see more and more product usage videos. And don't forget, every week on Thursday, I do Facebook Live from this location. I also do a thing called Nick at Nine. Nick at Nine is on Instagram. It's an Instagram story. Nick at Nine is all about what we're doing as a business, and it's a great way to ask for business advice. And then Brooklyn Live is me doing a couple of makeovers, and we're going to introduce guests into the Brooklyn Live in the coming months too. So thanks for taking some time out today. I hope you got to learn more about the Arogeo product line, more about the Arogeo ambassador process. And I would say that ultimately, when you become an Arogeo ambassador, we are going to get you connected to the Arogeo culture, the education, and really trying to focus constantly on being positive so you can be the best you can be. So thanks a lot, and if you're ever in New York, check us out.